Hello there, year six. We are going to continue our special studies concerning aquatic habitats. Aquatic invertebrates are the next topic. Please look at your book on page 121, 22, and 23 and look at the keywords. Please repeat them. Attach, bloodletting, breed, carapace, common house mosquito, crayfish, dragonfly, emperor dragonfly, European crayfish, European medicinal leech, fish spawn, leech, lime, mosquito, narrow clawed crayfish, piercing sucking mouth part, segmented worms, slender stalk stone crayfish, suction cup swan mussel, and vital. Now, let's concentrate on the different organisms which you can find there. The first one is the swan mussel. These are really typical everywhere in Hungary, rivers, lakes. These are part of the mollusk family, mollusks, puhatestűek. Their bodies are protected by a hard shell, which are made up of two halves and attached by a muscular hinge. They feed on plankton and other microscopic organisms, algae as well, so they can really nicely clean waters. Here you can see the different body parts. They also have a mantle which contains some inner organs, and they breathe through gills. The next one is the leech, which are in relation with segmented worms. They breathe through their skin, and they breed by laying eggs. The segmented body then is really typical. It's a bit like earthworms from that point of view. And if you check the different body parts, you can see here that they have suction cups. They are basically blood-sucking parasites, and they were used in medieval times especially, but even today for bloodletting, that's called köpölyözés in Hungarian. Sick people could be cured by using leeches. They are able to eat quite a lot in a single meal, so they can survive without food for months. Next one is the crayfish. There are different versions in Hungary. The European crayfish, narrow clawed crayfish, stone crayfish. Crayfish are protected in Hungary. They typically have the two main body parts, the cephalothorax, like spiders. They have the head of the thorax grown together, so it's the fusion of the two, which is typical, and the abdomen. They have five pairs of segmented legs, and the body is covered with a dark gray exoskeleton, which contains lime, which is mace, and other minerals, in addition to chitin. So they also have chitin in this exoskeleton. The minerals make the shell really hard and inflexible. The cephalothorax is covered with a hard shell, which we call the carapace. This protects the vital organs there. They have two compound eyes, and they have short movable stalks. Two sets of feelers are attached to the crayfish's head. Near the opening of the mouth, there are the jaws, which aid chewing. They are omnivores. They breathe by extracting oxygen from water using their gills. So they have gills here. The gills are at the base of each leg. So that's a very special structure here. The next one is the dragonfly. Again, an aquatic invertebrate with their long, slender bodies and the nice wings, which are see-through, transparent. They are really nice and attractive creatures near waters. But they are dangerous carnivores. They feed on fish spawn, tadpoles, and larvae of smaller insects. They have a short chewing mouth part for eating these. Their development is incomplete metamorphosis. You can just see some of the body parts here. And as you can see, the dragonfly's life cycle is the mentioned incomplete metamorphosis. The next is the mosquitoes. They are small grayish insects. They have slim bodies. They have the typical head, thorax, and abdomen, compound eyes. And the most important, which can make life really hard for you if you live near waters, is the piercing, sucking mouth part. And they have three pairs of long, segmented, or jointed legs. Mosquitoes feed on nectar and plant juices, but female animals need protein from basically blood to develop their eggs. So this is why they need to bite, and their bite is rather itchy and really irritating. So it can be quite annoying if you live close to waters. Unfortunately, they can also spread certain illnesses. Luckily, this is not a big danger in Hungary, but in Africa, you need to think of malaria, that kind of illness. The life cycle is very simple. They need water to develop. Females lay their eggs in the water. Eggs hatch into larvae. The larvae live in the water and then shed their skin several times as they grow. Then they have a pupa stage. And after this, the adult or imago insect appears. The development is complete metamorphosis. Here you can find an image of that. So this is what we checked here. Of course, you can find quite a lot of tasks in your workbook as well. So please have a look at your workbook at the aquatic invertebrate animals, page 121 and 22, this page I'm trying to show you. So you can start working on these 121 task 1, 2, 3 and 122 task 4, 5, 6 and 7. Keep up good work. Bye bye.